Hello again, I'm Sushma Khinvasara and welcome back to my channel. We began this series to showcase our local businesswomen and their small businesses. And this is the second part of the series. And today, we have a special guest, one of the many brave women out there who build their own businesses in the middle of pandemic. The owner and founder of Nora's Bakery, located right here in the city of Mississauga, Nora Bahgat. Please watch the video till the end. We have a great surprise from Nora for you. She's going to share with you one of her mouth-watering desserts, the chocolate bomb, and she'll show us how that's done. So please watch till the end. Do not leave the video in between. Hi, Nora. Welcome to the show. We are glad to have you today, Nora.
Hi. Thank you for having me. How are you doing today?
So today we are going to discover how Nora started running a business. Nora, tell us what made you decide to start Nora's Bakery.
So I first started baking back when I was in grade 6. And back then, I used to, I made like things like chocolate cake, and then I also went and made chocolate chip cookies. And there was like a time that I almost like, I remember like almost burning the house down because like I was making chocolate chip cookies and then I was trying to make a batch and then they almost like burnt. Oh, actually they burnt and then yeah, I almost burnt the house down. But yeah, that's like, that was basically way back when I, the very early stages of my business. And then after that, I took a lot more courses. And then it was mostly all the courses that I took along the way that helped me to want to pursue and like start my own bakery.
That's very inspiring, Nora, especially for someone like me who doesn't like baking, and you started baking at a very early age. So it is awesome that you did not give up your dream to have your own bakery business. Speaking of your business, Nora, do you intend starting your own, you started your online baking business last year, is that correct?
So I first started my own business back in May of 2020, and it was after I took two business courses. Both of them were actually funded by the government. One of the courses was a great opportunity for me to pitch my business idea and then bring that to, and that honestly honored me to be chosen as well to receive a grant of up to $5,000. And then the other one as well was just another opportunity to really put together like a whole business plan as well. And then actually recently, back a couple months ago, I also received another grant where I received $2,000 as well. So that was good for like kitchen rental, etc. and marketing.
That's inspiring. So you started your business in the midst of pandemic. Has it actually impacted your business? And how did you respond to that challenge, Nora?
Yes, so definitely COVID did have an impact on our business when I first started, definitely in particular in the early stages, once like there was like lockdown, and then lockdown meant like no gatherings, and then that was like, for example, like things like large weddings, it weren't really any wedding orders at all. It was mostly cakes that were like 4-inch cakes, 5-inch cakes on average. But then recently, I would say now that the pandemic is like starting to things are finally starting to open up, and so I would say I'm starting to get a lot more bigger like cake orders in terms of like 8-inch, 6-inch, around that. And then also another thing about my business is that I offer accessible options in terms of like halal baked goods. Then I also have like vegan options, and then I'm based in Mississauga, but I also do delivery across the GTA and then shipping across Canada and the USA.
Oh, that was a great area that you came up to bring joy in people's life despite the pandemic. So Nora, what more can you tell me about your business?
So Nora's Bakery is a new online business. I started off as an online business, but now I operate from a shared commercial kitchen here in Mississauga called the EK Collective. And then I focus on halal, custom cookies, cupcakes, cakes, and more. And then what makes it unique is that I offer a variety of options, including vegan, gluten-free, vegetarian, low-sugar options, etc. And everything is made from scratch without any like preservatives, etc. And yeah.
It's really great that you're accommodating different dietary options, which when it's sometimes difficult to find. So Nora, what do you think are the advantages of owning your own business?
So my favorite aspect of like having my own business, it's definitely the flexible schedule, that's one thing. And then also it's like a lot less stress when it comes to doing something that you truly love. And also just the privilege to work whenever you want, in terms of like having like a balanced work-life schedule, for things like, you know, your at-home lifestyle versus your work lifestyle as well. And it's like when you do something you love, it starts to feel like something, it doesn't feel like work anymore essentially.
Yes, it's true. Nora, ever since you started your own bakery businesses as an entrepreneur, what challenges have you faced and are experiencing?
So one of the biggest challenges for me when I first started my own business was not having someone to hold you accountable. That's definitely really hard. It's like a big transition from when you're working for someone and then you have like a boss, etc. And so you end up like procrastinating a lot, etc. And then also just like the inconsistency in the number of customers that I was getting. So some weeks I was doing well, for example, whenever there was like special occasions, etc. But then when it was like a lot slower, there weren't any special holidays, and it really slowed down then.
Mm-hmm. That really made a difference in your this. Okay, you're right. You know, actually, challenges in businesses do make us strong and think of much better ideas to do how our businesses and how to carry it forward. Nora, so today, Nora, you also prepared something for us to share with the viewers. You prepared, I believe it's a chocolate bomb, which we are going to see later on. I'm really excited to see that. So Nora today prepared for us some of her best-selling and delicious handmade cakes and cookies, and it's my honor to have them tested for you guys. So Nora, what do we have here today?
So for today, as you can see, everything here is actually all vegan and vegetarian, which means it's like dairy-free and then egg-free as well. And I figured I'd go for like a summer theme kind of thing. We're in the summertime. So as you can see here, so everything is summer theme. And then we have here like the vegan hot chocolate bombs. And these are basically made out of vegan chocolate and then vegan hot cocoa powder as well, along with vegan marshmallows. And then they can be served with either like hot milk or water.
Okay, and what do we have here?
We have the chocolate covered strawberries.
Wow.
And then this is also made with vegan chocolate. And then this one is the real summer treat.
Oh yeah, it's a fruit cake. Yeah. Very nice, very creative, very nice of you to think about it. And what do we have here?
So these are the vegan vanilla cupcakes with strawberries, and then so it's pretty much a vegan strawberry shortcake cupcake.
Okay, and these? Mm-hmm.
And these are just the same thing but without the icing.
Oh, mm-hmm. I see. So they're just cupcakes.
Yeah.
Excellent. My mouth is watering. Nora, I really needed to taste all of them, and I'm going to taste some of them if you don't mind, because I can't resist myself. I'm going to start with this one first. It's nice, quite soft, moist, very nice.
Mm-hmm.
Excellent. This one I'm going to taste. This is the same thing, right? Same but this is the without the...
Without the icing.
Did you put banana in it or...?
No, actually, this is made out of flax seeds. Mm. So you grind the flax seeds and that's why the egg replacing. Yeah.
And this is the strawberries.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Wow, nice taste to it. I love everything of yours. I really feel that simple and nice, but you've really made your creations are lovely. All of them look delicious. And my most favorite one was the cupcake with the... It's made out of flaxseed. We can't even make out it's made out of flaxseed.
Yeah, thank you.
I'm very deep. I can't get over how deliciously your handmade cakes and cookies are. I will definitely suggest and recommend this to everyone. So if you are looking for a custom cake or cookies and more, I recommend, highly recommend you to visit Nora's bakery and visiting her on the bakery online. They're offering halal custom cakes, cupcakes, cookies and much more, and also have a variety of dietary options, vegan, vegetarian, low sugar and much more. In the future, Nora, what do you hope to achieve from your business?
So one of my dream goals in the future is to have my own storefront somewhere in Mississauga. So right now I operate from a shared commercial kitchen. So basically we have different like bakeries that all like work in one place. In the future I want to have like my own bakery, and then also I'd love to also be able to offer shipping options like globally or across the entire world.
That's a great goal for your business, Nora. Can't wait to see your bakery or store one day. Now Nora, if you had one tip to give to someone, what would that be?
So one tip that I would recommend is when, especially when you're first starting off, is that you want to have your recipe written out in terms of like the ingredients and then the instructions as well. Like really be like, follow the recipe exactly in terms of the ingredients and then also the instructions. Like you'd be surprised that just like following the recipe in terms of the exact quantities, how much of a difference that makes.
Okay. And, Thank you, Nora, for giving that tip. It really helps a lot of people. And I also wanted to know, if people wanted to order from you online, how do they do that?
There are various ways that customers can actually contact us. So for example, through email, along with our social media, such as Facebook and Instagram, also by phone, and a website as well. And then you can even find us on Google, so we're also on there as well. And then we just require a 3 to 5 day notice for all custom orders in particular. And then customers can place their order using e-transfer as the recommended method, but you can also make payments there through our website as well.
Thank you, Nora. I will put Nora's all contact information in the description below. And share with your friends and family. Again, Nora, thank you for taking your time and coming down here and answering all the questions that were asked to you. Also for letting us taste all these delicious products and giving us inspiring advice.
Yeah, thank you so much for having me.
Okay. Also, Nora, just before we let our viewers go, I would like you to share the recipe for the chocolate bomb, if that's okay with you. I know we are also going to be putting up a video of you sharing, but if you can just share the recipe, that would be great.
Yeah, definitely. So as I was saying earlier, these are made with vegan chocolate and then also vegan marshmallows, along with about 1 tablespoon of the hot chocolate mix, which is vegan hot chocolate. And then you just like serve it with either hot milk or hot water. And then that's basically it.
I will be posting her video also with the recipe. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Take care.